Kindly sit down. Thank you for the courtesy. May the commander of the troops, may I request you to give the tikas pahinga order, please.
Tikas. Ha!
Executive Secretary Salvador Miguel Díaz and the other members of the Cabinet, AFP Chief of Staff General Eduardo Aniu, and the Major Service Commanders, Lieutenant General Edgar Valorina, Lieutenant General Galileo Gerard Quintana Jr., the officers, enlisted personnel, and civilian employees of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, mga kasama ko sa gobyerno, mga mahal kong kababayan. It is my pleasure to join you in the Pops Change of Command and Retirement Ceremony of Lieutenant General Edgar Valorina. I congratulate Lieutenant General Valorina for his successful tour of duty as Commander General of the Philippine Air Force. I am confident that the PAF is in good order with several improvements initiated by Lieutenant General Valorina and the upgrades made under his administration. The PAF has made remarkable organizational improvement under his leadership. He has established the command framework, jointly engaged and transforming force of greater peace and security. Under his leadership, the Tactical Operations Command and the Air Defense Command were reactivated. The Philippine Air Force also performed aerial reconnaissance and maritime patrol missions over the West Philippine Sea, the Benham Rise, and the other parts of the Philippine territory. You have supported internal security operations, mainly on the ongoing military operation in Mindanao, where the PAF provided the air assets for troop movement and the close air support to ground troops against the Abu Sayyaf group and the other terrorist groups. Humanitarian assistance and disaster response operations has been an aerial observation over calamity-stricken areas, an airlift of assisting personnel, relief goods and victims were done as well. The PAF has also employed several aircraft and more than 400 personnel to Marawi for combat support and troop movement operations. I assure you that the PAF has made the government full support as you perform your mandate as an organization. In fact, two 130s and 12 FE-50 aircraft has been added to the PAF since July of last year. I enjoin our troops to continue performing their duties as well, especially as under martial law remains in effect in Mindanao, and there are persisting threats of terrorism and counterinsurgency. We recognize the valor, the sacrifice of the PAF personnel who were killed and wounded in action, particularly the casualties caused by the conflict in Marawi City. Rest assured that the Philippines is committed to promote the welfare of all PAF personnel and their loved ones. That you have left your families and the comfort of your homes to serve the country is truly praiseworthy. Indeed, the Philippines and our people are indebted to you because of the sacrifices that you have made every single day. We have made significant headway in ridding the country of the scourges of criminality, insurgency, terrorism, and corruption because of your invaluable contributions, and there could be never be a task more ennobling than that. May you always stay faithful to the Constitution and the people whom you have sworn to protect. Truly, you have made our country safer and more secure. Good day and mabuhay ang Philippine Air Force. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Oh.